And we here are now, we're gonna make a switch and I have to do a proper introduction because our next guest is a big one. We're calling in all the way to Moscow, Russia to speak with Oleg Androzov, and he is the founder of the film studio and film school LizArt, where young pupils can delve into the world of cinema and storytelling in film. And now, this film school is a special one, not only because Oleg is leading it, but also because he has a background in film that is, I mean, quite big. He's a member of the Russian Writers Union. He's also a member of the jury at the Toronto International Film Festival. And yeah, all his work centers around film, and it also centers around showing how amazing the art of storytelling can be. So Oleg, I want to thank you for joining us from Russia. How are you? How is Russia?
Как у вас дела?
Прекрасно. Надеюсь, вы все здоровы, в добром здравии.
Hello, happy to see you. I hope you're well.
Thank you. I'm sorry, I didn't get the name of our translator here today. What is your name?
My name is Tatiana.
Tatiana, thank you for translating this today for us. And what a beautiful dress you have on.
Thank you.
Now, Oleg, let's start at the school, right? How young are pupils at the LizArt Film School in Russia?
Олег, давайте начнем с вашей школы в России. Как ваша школа киноиндустрии в России?
Да замечательно, наша индустрия растет и процветает. В частности, наша детская киношкола тоже. Приходит все больше и больше талантливых детей. Мы, естественно, даем им возможность раскрывать и развивать свои таланты. Ну и, собственно, результаты вы видите на фестивалях, в том числе и на вашем фестивале.
So it's very beautiful right now. We're growing all the time, and you can see our results on your kino industry.
Ah, perfect.
And it's it's more young, talented people than children there.
Wow. And how? What kind of classes do they get? Like, what does he teach them exactly?
Что вы им преподаете и именно какое направление?
В нашей киношколе дети, помимо, естественно, актерского мастерства, получают базовые основы кинорежиссуры, операторского искусства и сценарного искусства.
In our kino industry school, we are learning how to, so it's like acting.
Mm-hmm.
Operating. Also lessons. So it's like full
scenario.
It's like full complex of different classes.
Wow. Now he's teaching them the entire spectrum of filmmaking, I'm guessing here. So why does he do that? Why is his mission to teach filmmaking to the younger kids in Russia on his film school?
Почему вы решили вот именно заняться этим, именно обучать детей?
Ну, это такая очень длинная история, но если вкратце, в разговоре, в беседе с моим коллегой, известным, собственно, на весь мир, обладателем Оскара, с Никитой Сергеевичем Михалковым, он мне как-то сказал, что в нашем регионе, вот в котором я проживаю, в Краснодарском крае, очень много талантливых детей, но развиваться им негде. Это послужило для меня толчком.
Я переведу. So it's a very long story, but I want to start with, you know, everybody know our great teacher Михалков. So, and we was talking with him, and he said, like, we have too much talented children in Russia, but we don't have any space where they can grow in.
Вот, это послужило для меня толчком для того, чтобы открыть киношколу на базе уже действующей киностудии, которая много лет уже у нас работает.
So, and from this point, I decided to open a kino industry school. But the base was on the Oxford.
Wow. Yeah. So there's two things I'm taking away from this. First of all, he noticed that there's a lot of talent around. And then second of all, he also noticed that there wasn't a school to bring that talent to actually teach them the art and the practical side of filmmaking. I am wondering, if you have a film school and you get all these young pupils in, and he's an expert on film, but what did he learn from them? Is there something that they taught him about film?
Да, я восхищен очень вашей работой. И что думают ваши ученики про школу? Как они относятся к этому?
Наши воспитанники, мы их воспитанниками называем, они воспринимают нашу киношколу как свой второй дом, и между занятиями они постоянно общаются друг с другом, и постоянно общаются с нами, с педагогами, и мы всегда слышим, что «Ой, скорее бы суббота, скорее бы воскресенье, мы очень хотим в киношколу, мы так соскучились», бегут с удовольствием.
Our students, for them, it's like second home, our киношколу. And we feel together like a family, and our school is like a second home for our students. And in available time, we're talking, meeting with each other. So, and with every free time, they're coming to our school.
Oh, wow. So I'm guessing, so what he means is that there's like a community that exists around the film school that is outside of the classes, but it's just the kids like creating collaborations, maybe working together even. Is that so?
Да, это звучит как это как комьюнити, то есть больше, чем просто школа, и все ученики увлечены процессом и вместе тренируются, что-то создают и делают.
Да, именно так. Именно поэтому дети называют нашу киношколу именно семьей. Это они сами так это называют, а меня между собой, до меня это дошло, в прошлом году, и я, собственно, не сопротивляюсь, меня называют не иначе, как Папа Лис.
Yeah, this is true, and they really feel like this is the second home, and so they call me, like, Father Fox, and our school, like, home.
Why Father?
So yeah, it's community.
Is there something it's that I'm missing in the translation? Funny. Why is he Father Fox? Is he a very foxy person? Maybe I don't even want to know.
Почему отец Лис?
Ну, у нас киношкола, как собственно и киностудия в русском наречии называется Лис Арт. Когда я основывал киностудию и киношколу, ну, собственно, мое любимое животное лис, я долго не мучился с названием.
When I was creating this kinoschool, I created this name Fox because my favorite animal is fox.
Ah, that's a logical explanation. Now, stay with us here, Moscow, because we are gonna see a little clip, but first I have to introduce the clip. And the clip, I think, is from the film Hashtag. It's a film from the Lizards Children Film School. And it means that children took part in all stages of creating this film. So it went from discussing the idea of the script, to filming it, to acting in it, to editing it, to releasing it. And now the film is about children's dependence on gadgets. You'll see that in the clip I'm showing you. But important to know is that this film actually won on the International Film Festival, the iPhone Film Festival. It won in the category Best Student Film. Now, I think that is an amazing treat. We're speaking here with the director and the founder of that school, and like, I really want to know, how did this film get so good? But first, let's take a look at it. This is Hashtag.
Thank you.
Wow, that is a terrific trailer. First of all, who's there's two things I want to know. I'm sorry that I'm bugging you with this amount of questions, but first of all, what is that, like, whose iPhone is that being thrown against the wall? Like, explain the iPhone throwing. And then second of all, the director of this film is just 14 years old. How was this film even made?
Тому, кто вот участвовал в этом фильме, 14 лет, да?
От 7 до 14.
Как это ему удалось вообще от 7 до 14 лет так эмоционально это все сыграть?
Ну, как бы мы же не просто работаем с детьми с улицы, мы берем-то их с улицы, но мы же над ними работаем, с ними работают педагоги по актерскому мастерству, раскрывают их таланты, преображают, учат, как правильно подавать эмоции.
Yeah, it was a big job with children. So, yeah, they are so young, from seven years old to 14 years old. But it's a huge. It's a lot of teachers was working with them to create this. What but they all came.
Can he just, for my personal interest, ask him, like, whose iPhone was it that was thrown there? Because me as a 14-year-old, I would never throw my iPhone against the wall.
Это чей был iPhone, который на который снимали?
I can see him smiling, so there's a story here.
На который снимали или который разбили?
Да-да-да, на который разбили. Насколько он был мощным?
Если мне память не изменяет, это, по-моему, был восьмой iPhone, и мы его покупали, ну, такой бэушный, с рук, он, правда, был рабочий, но специально покупали для съемок, мы покупали два таких iPhone, потому что понимали, что может не получиться за один дубль, покупали два бэушных iPhone именно для этой сцены, для того, чтобы разбить его об стену, но сняли с одного дубля.
We bought two used iPhones, it was the iPhone 8. So, but we did it from first time. So, second one iPhone was stay alive, but we bought just two iPhones for this.
The secret to iPhone smashing: always have two with you. now, this film won an award, and you can see that there's like a tremendous amount of cinematic quality in it. What can you ask for me if he expects the creators of this film, like all the young pupils that worked on it, to continue working in film?
Excuse me, can you...
Do you expect the creators of this film to keep on working in the film industry? Are these people, are these young pupils thinking about careers in movie and in storytelling?
Как вы считаете, дети, вот, которые создали этот фильм, они будут продолжать свое будущее, связанное с киноиндустрией, более профессионально развиваться? Или это просто как такие истории вот только на данном этапе созданы?
Не то, что будут. Они продолжают, они занимаются у нас до сих пор, большинство из них. И после прошлогодней премии на фестивале iPhone Film Festival. Они выиграли еще фестиваль в Нью-Йорке, они выиграли Всероссийский кинофестиваль. Сейчас они номинированы на Всероссийскую кинопремию. То есть они продолжают работать. Мы после этого сняли уже 4 или 5 фильмов, и один лучше другого, скажем так. И в этом году мы тоже заявились на ваш фестиваль, кстати, с парочкой новых работ.
Yeah, children still going to create new films, and we had a lot of. We was a winner in New York iPhone Festival, and in Russia Festival also we was a winner, and also we are waiting your festival because we will show two new films. So children in the process, and we are learning, growing, and have a new. So going to a new level without non-stop.
Wow, such a creative field you guys are setting up there in Russia. There is another fragment of a student film that we can look at. Do you know if he wants to do an introduction for us? Can you help me with that?
У нас тоже много фильмов новых снимается. So you mean like they created a lot of new films, and can he do introduction for their new film, right?
Oh no, I have a fragment of a filmer, but I'll just start it in and then we'll discuss it right afterwards. This is a fragment of the film Peel. Thanks for what can you tell me about this film? This was also made by younger students. I feel like this is a lighter themed film, so was this also made by younger kids?
А вот этот фильм, который мы сейчас показывали, кем он был снят, тоже
Этот фильм, да, он был полностью от и до сделан нашими воспитанниками, ребятами. Вот, я всего лишь немножко подкорректировал сценарий и подсказывал где-то немножко на съемочной площадке, но все они делали сами. Там режиссер ребенок, оператор ребенок, все актеры дети. То есть там полностью они все делали сами. Это их учебная практика.
Yeah, this film, it was their practice. So they did it all. I mean, all without me. I was just a little bit helping. But actors was a children, operator was a child. And this is just was their like a homework or, you know, practice job. And I was just a little helping.
Wow. It's been, Katja, you have to help me here. How do I say thank you for joining us today in Russian? How do I thank him for joining us? What do I say in Russian?
Спасибо большое за то, что присоединились к нам сегодня.
Oh no, that's
спасибо
too difficult.
Большое, до новых встреч.
You lost me there. Well, can you tell him that I at least wanted to try to say thank you in Russian? And again, I've been blown away. You're doing such a great job in helping these younger kids create stories through mobile filmmaking. So thank you for that. And I wish you like all the best with coming film festivals.
Очень важную работу для детей в России. Спасибо вам большое.
Спасибо. До новых встреч.
The only thing I know is Nazdrovia, but it's too early here in Netherlands.
Thank you.
Thank you. We are switching seats here. We're cleaning everything up following COVID protocols. And then we have the last masterclass of the day. We'll be hearing from Polina Medvedeva and Isaura Sanvir Yatmo. And they'll be talking about the most interactive documentary I've seen this year. I've been blown away by it. They just came back from the Netherlands Film Festival. And they're here already to talk about what exactly they've been creating and working on. So we'll be right back. It is 5 minutes. And this next short is one of our favorites.
Thank you. feet up, the glass will shatter. Tear it down.
Good job!